So now we will move forward to our next speaker. Now we welcome Dr. Fadia Shah, who will be speaking on human-computer interaction patterns enhancement for human user interface recognition. I request Dr. Fadia Shah to share the screen and start the presentation.
Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamu alaikum everyone. I hope all can hear me.
Yes ma'am, you are audible. Okay. You can proceed.
Okay, just give me a second to share my screen.
Yes ma'am, it is visible now. You can proceed.
Thank you for update. I'm basically focusing on human-computer interaction and basically the enhancement that is being carried out by human-computer interaction on user interface. Particularly, what I try to say is nowadays everything is becoming digitized and there are a lot of systems that are helping and facilitating the users by every means. So human-computer interaction, that is a very well-known, familiar, and mostly the people that use computers and the apps, they are very well aware of how computers have a good impact on the human beings. What are the patterns that enhance? So human-computer interaction is not very web development based or user interface type the thing. It particularly improves how the facilitation of the computer systems are improving the quality of life. The main concern my presentation is basically sometimes we design the systems, the user interface is very important and how they are actually facilitating the systems. So in particularly for example when the people they try to sell their products, so the user interface plays a very important role. And similarly when the academicians they want to explore the research studies, again, the user interface is very important, so we can discriminate the systems that actually based upon e-commerce systems and the system that they are based upon human learning systems. We see the interface is quite different. For example, achieving goals within constraints. So this is the focus of human-computer interaction for user interface. So it means whatever goal the product aims to be and how these goals are being achieved. So user interface plays a very vital role. Goals are the purpose. It means who is it for? Why do they want it? So what is our goal? For example, if an e-commerce based system, the web development or website is being developed, the key emphasis is basically to sell the products. Product itself has some worth, but how the products are represented, it plays a very vital role. So first of all, we have to clarify what is the goal and for which goal we are going to develop our design systems. Constraints are some materials, platforms, some rules and regulations through which we actually facilitate to sell our products. Third thing is the trade-off. Trade-off technically is the benefit. Whatever system we have in case of digitized products or website or e-commerce based or even research based platforms or apps, what is the trade-off? What is the benefit the user is getting? What is the benefit that the people who are developing they will get? And that actually, what is the design? They actually emphasize or they actually aim or they participate in the system design. So goals, constraints and trade-off, they are three key important factors that actually decide what should be the design of our product. Okay, the central message here we have is the user. So whatever we do, whatever these systems are doing, they have the main target that facilitation of the users. How the systems are being designed, or when we emphasize, or if I say, when we target the category of the users, for example, the product is based upon selling the product to a particular age group, or a particular gender, or a particular group of cycle or circle. So it actually defines how our system design will be looking like. So here, this is a cycle basically, or this is a flow. What is wanted? The people, they decide, they actually clarify what is wanted. It's very important. Sometimes we used to have that, show people what actually they want, show people what they need. Until and unless they don't realize what the system can be, they will be unable to facilitate to buy it. So what is wanted? It requires proper analysis. Nowadays, we are having a lot of analysis systems. We are having a lot of data. Everyone is updating their information, even their personal lives on the social media sector. And this data is, for us, it's free. Porach's popularity. So we just upload a lot of data, things that are very attractive, and they give them again popularity in various cycles. So this data is analyzed, and based upon the analysis of this data, some patterns are being found and the systems are designed. So it means our data, the single bit of information that we update just to get attention of other people, it's very important. And analyzing this data actually convert the system designs. And this design is implemented and deployed in various final projects and various applications in various projects that are being organized and developed and deployed by the organizations. So in design, we have a reverse cycle that actually prototype. So in design patterns, we specify what we have to do, what we have to design. And in prototype, we declare how these products are being designed. And once the prototype is finalized and it is analyzed again, so it means this is a cycle that actually completes the aim and objective of what is being required. So the process of design is not very simple, or it is not a simple flow. Or even sometimes when we design something or we finalize something, we even have to change it. That is even the base of software engineering as well. So what is wanted? We get this information based upon interviews. What is there, what it is versus what is wanted. So what the systems are in existing phase, for example, Kareem, Uber, in drives, there are a lot of applications already available. If these applications are already available and they are executing in the normal, they are running businesses. So what is the need that we are getting some new apps? So it means there is some labs, or even these systems, they are designed, they still have some bottlenecks. And the next system they are being developed, they actually identify the research gap or the product gap. And finding this gap, the new products are being initialized and they occupy the market space. For example, if I say about InDrive, why InDrive is existing when there was Kareem? So what is the difference between both of them? So it means when the Kareem will change the policy up to InDrive, InDrive basically facilitates the users. They ask them, the users can set some value. So ultimately, we can get some ranking from the Kareem as well. Apart from that, there are financial constraints and so on. Next thing comes from interviews, we get what is wanted. Then scenarios, task analysis, for analysis. Analysis phase, as we all, mostly of us are belonging to the category of software engineering and software development or IT-based systems background. So we are very well aware that the scenarios are being analyzed. And in design, the guideline principles. So design is not very simple. It's not just a theme or anything only attractive or whatever we see fascinating and we just apply in our designs. So these are designs are basically based upon some guidelines or some principles. And when these designs are implemented, so these specifications are precise and perfectly designed so that the user can engage to the system and the system is being more efficiently utilized when the system design is very attractive. In the sense that they are eye-catching and they are engaging the users in the different methods. So the prototype, that is a dialogue notations. So it means the design is when converted into the prototype. So it again has some rules and regulations. For example, dialogue notations, how the input is being carried out, will it be converted into the output and so on. So evaluation heuristics, it means based upon the experiences and first outcome, second, third, and fourth outcome will be deployed, and even the risk factors are being calculated. In case of implementation and deployment, the architectures and documentation. So when we say what is the benefit of the documentation, so in implementation, the complete process is being explained. In documentation, it means our project is particularly specified according to the needs and requirements. So in general, if we summarize requirements, what are they and what is wanted? Analysis is basically ordering and understanding. Design is what to do and how to decide. Now for any product, design is very important. And in case of any system, the success is basically, I must say, all the requirements or analysis or implementation, all phases are most important, but the design has a long lasting impact. Interaction, prototyping, as I told you, getting it right and finding what is really needed and so on. Implementation and deployment, so it means making it and getting it out there. So that is the final output. So these are the steps that we must follow. In this slide, for example, navigation design, sometimes the user is not very much interested in the static or isolated designs. So the user want to have some clicks. The user should be engaged to the system by displaying different icons and buttons and anything that is basically helpful for that candidate to be reside on the system. So if you think, for example, just like this is a page, this is a slide, and there is nothing I can click, there is nothing I can fill out, there is nothing of my interest, so I will be annoyed from this page very soon. So for the system, for example, if there is a website that actually facilitates the students, so there are two methods. First is only lecture slides that are being uploaded or the video lectures. The second thing is to make it interactive. So when we have introduction from the students, from the candidate, so the system will be having a good awareness that what system actually is providing and what the user is actually looking for. And this output is actually very helpful for the user to enhance or improve the quality of the system design. So logical structure, that is a single screen. Global structure, it means that whole site. So it means preferably the dynamic websites or dynamic designs, they cover the global structure where the different web pages are connected and they are interlinked, maybe in the start, maybe in the end, maybe in sideways, maybe in the text. So different pages are interconnected. The people who are aware about this search engine optimization, they are having a good idea about the global structure. So it also improves the ranking and the quality of the website. So this is basically the system design that improves the quality of the system. Widget choice, menus, buttons. So attractive buttons are least important. First of all, the main concern is how many buttons for what and buttons for why. Screen design, understand the logical grouping of buttons. So it means the same content or same type of context in the buttons will be grouped together so that the student or the candidate can be able to find the relevant icons. Application navigation design, what will happen when the button is pressed? So display was the previous step. And after display, what information the user is expected to get? So the candidate will be having a mindset. So after pressing the button, the candidate will be thinking about, okay, I will be getting this information in coming time. But what displays to the candidate, maybe the candidate will be enhanced. Maybe the person will be interestedly explore the page. Or maybe if whatever is being displayed on the page, it's very disappointing. It's very few information and maybe it's not linked. So the design patterns include not only the buttons, but what information one can get. Environment, other application, operating system, etc. So it means the simpler and the refiner things, they will be more facilitating. So these are the levels through which the user interact with the operating system or the online systems or the systems which are actually applicable to the system designs. The local one from the screen looking out. So it means everything is available on one page. Either the website is dynamic, either there is a database that is being connected, but most of the information is available on the one page. So it's like goal seeking, just like this diagram that is being represented. From start, we start, the system is being start, and the goal is up to there. The goal seeking is actually, there is a chain, there is a cycle, or there is a path that is being developed by the developer, by the analyst, by the system designer. And there are a lot of patches. And there are a lot of directions through which the person can move towards the goal. But the start to goal, the path may not be the very simple or may not be the very, very straight. So there are curves. Sometimes we have to change our requirement. Sometimes we have to change the design. Sometimes even we have to change in terms of whenever the prototype is being developed and so on. Once everything is being finalized, so from start till goal, the things are being completed. But you can see here the thread indicates that it's not a very straight or simple path. So there are zigzags, there are changes, there are modifications, but finally the goal is achieved. This is a curve. Now, system design plays an important part in terms of when human-computer interaction study, ergonomics is being studied. Ergonomics is basically the human psyche and human understanding and the computer systems. So what human being thinks and how the systems are being represented, it plays a very vital role. So here we can see that it may not be the very simple. Sometimes it utilizes the lot of resources that are unplanned. Four golden rules for human computer interaction studies for user interface. Knowing where you are, knowing what you can do, knowing where you are going or what will happen, knowing where you have been or what you have done. So it means at full, the person who is going to design the system should be aware of at which level or which stage the person or candidate is. So where you are, it means if you are starting a design pattern, so you should be aware of the analysis. Then what you can do, it means what type of system and what possible option you can do. So how you can frame your concepts. Knowing where you are going, it means how much content you have developed and what thing is left behind. Knowing where you have been, it means it's again the completion and uncompleted phase awareness. So for example, you can see this is one of the website. So shows the path through website hierarchy, where you are. So it means here you are representing something with the cartoon element. So sometimes the written text is not very worthy, but the picture is. So it means, for example, if you are unable to get a relevant answer, 7 common errors. So it also has some relevant diagrams. So basically the person can be more understanding by this diagram instead of this content. Website, top level category, subcategory, and this page. So this is a hierarchy of your website. So it means these are the number of pages and that are being connected, and this is your main website, the main page and its representation. Live links to higher levels. So it means these are the main levels and these are the pages that will be replaced. Beware of the button trap. So sometimes we say that in design pattern, the buttons, the shape of the buttons are very important. Yes, indeed, they are very important. But have you ever thought about be aware of the button trap? Where do they go? Lots of room for extra text. So it means sometimes the buttons, they may not represent the complete information. For example, if we say home, so everybody knows that home is the basic home page. Okay, there are 4 button examples that are being represented here. On one button, only one text, one word is written. And on 2 buttons, there are other things, more things. And on the last button, the thing from outer space, it means how the text will be looking on the button. That also has some important in the system design. So this is a very big button and very small text. This is a big button as well as the text. The size of text is also very big. And these 2 are the buttons that have a remarkable size, as well as the length of the words is also tangible. So again, how the text being orientated, other things, more things, which one is the more suitable thing? So selection of words come next. So it means buttons are trapped. Are they providing you the exact information, or what should be mentioned? What should be the layout of the buttons? Buttons, again, the modes. So you remember this phone, it contains some simpler buttons and there were some modes. Behind every button, there was complete function, complete representation, complete circuit. So sometimes we look at the locks. So sometimes, for example, 404 not found. So some codes are reserved for some pages that are not found. And if the user is waiting and the page is not being displayed, it may annoy the user. So in your design pattern, is it possible that somebody has declared that, okay, if the user has to wait for a long time, what will be this patience level? So now we are moving in the era of smart technology. We can't wait more than a few milliseconds. So we are just waiting, okay, system is not working, so make it end and move to the other system. So it means now the people are not able to wait. So you have some pattern, you have some idea that how your system design is engaging this user. You have something, for example, in Windows, whenever you are sitting and loading the Windows, so the system engages you. Please wait in a few minutes, the screen will be displayed and some icons and some flows, they are being represented. So this is one of the example of excellent design, that the user is being engaged, even he is doing nothing and the system is doing everything. You see, so the main icons, these are the main modes, and other buttons are the representations. Global. So when we say about the global design pattern. This means a lot of pages are being engaged with each other between screens within the applications. So switching the pages. So hierarchical diagrams. So it means first of all, in design patterns, you have to clearly indicate what type of designs your system will be indicating. The system information and help, that is one section. Management of what the user. So it will have two other modules. Messages, that is the static part, the static information of the your website. So it means you have to draw the block diagram of your system design. Screen then groups. So sometimes we group the similar activities together. Network diagrams. So what will be the system flow? What will be the information flow? So it means the design will be so simple so that every candidate will be able to understand the system easily. Screen design and layout. What should be the screen design? For example, at the bottom you can see there is a diagram. It contains some sections, some blocks, some text. So what will be the layout? The basic principles, grouping, structure, order alignment, use of white spaces and so on. So these factors actually improve the layout of your system design. Basic principle for system design in HCI asks what the user is doing. Think what information, comparisons, order. So basically this term think, in the long era we relate this term think with the data mining design. From follows function. That means some forms will be developed. It has some functions that will be actually linked together. Multiple columns. So in some system designs, if you are representing a lot of columns, so a few columns is okay. It actually indicates what your system will be having basic information. But too many columns with representation of a table, sometimes it may confuse the candidate. So the main concern is to make some columns. By clicking some column, it should be moving toward the next level with the same category and so on. So it will be very easy and facilitating for the user to understand and being engaged to the system. What you see, white space. In this slide particularly, you can see that what you see is the main text. All of the text is at the bottom with one line. And complete, the slide has no text. The slide is completely blank. So it means the importance of white spaces is never ignored. So white spaces after that, a button or a text or anything, actually improves the readability of the content. So my last slide, user interface is quite important because it helps to engage the users. So in this slide, I have represented some of the common platform. For example, when we say about Google, and you see the user interface is very simple. It contains no ad, no other information, only one text box, Google search, and I'm feeling lucky. So it actually is representing only valuable thing, relevant thing, and I'm feeling lucky means some psychological tricks through which the user is thinking that, okay, I am valuable, I have some importance. So with the positive thought. On the right side, on the top, you can see the RAS. So this is again another website. So this is the user interface for e-commerce based websites. And if you see this website, it's so much glowy, it's having so much rich in colors, shades, representations, and the mixture of colors and icons, and so many links. So it should be eye-catching because the user is now, this website is facilitating the user. But the Google, the user is self-motivated, and the user has to find something. But the RAS website, that is actually engaging the user. So it will be giving or throwing some options of user's interest. So the icon or representation or the layout or system design in case of the RAS is very different as compared to the Google. But if you see, the functionality of the Google is much diverse as compared to the RAS. So in diversity, apparently the things are very relevant, very simple. So it means they are not distracting the user's thought. Similarly, this is third website, that is HEC, Higher Education Commission of Pakistan. You see there are some icons, but with some soft colors, but with some not too many rashi. And very, very basic categories of. So it means grouping icons together. So when we click any of them, so they will be indicating some more relevant icons, but in the next page and only relevant information. Similarly, at the below left side, we can see BBC website. So it actually represents the text along with some icons and in pictorial form. Even sometimes there are some videos that are animated as well. You can see here the second picture. So it means this is eye-catching, but actually it attains or it's very attentive about your attention. When the user sees BBC, oh, so many threads. So ultimately, all of his focus divert to BBC and towards this information system. The system is actually motivating the user, okay, this is also a problem, this is also a problem. The last one, that is online games. Now, if you compare all of them, you can see the online games again, very simple background, but very dense and saturated buttons or icons. So they are all linked towards the games. So these were actually five websites through which you can see system designs, and depending on the user thought and criteria and target. So these five patterns are entirely different to each other, although they are all digitized informations, and these all are the basic information extraction sources. But you see the layout of everyone is quite different from each other. So this is why thinking about the human nature and human computer systems are being developed, and the design is very important in this concern. So that's all from my side. If you have any questions, you're welcome.
Thank you, ma'am, for your enlightening presentation. Does anyone have any questions or comments for Dr. Fadia Shah, ma'am, before we move forward? Thank you so much, ma'am, for your kind words and participation.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you.